Hi everybody, Big Pauly back for another top 5 countdown video. This video will be my top 5 Star Wars moments from all of the movies. So 5 straight down to 1. There are a lot of scenes that and moments that won't be included in this where they may be high on other people's lists, but doing a top 5 you're very limited. But these are my favourite Star Wars moments of all of them. So let's start the countdown at number 5. Okay guys, so my number 5 on my list is the Star Wars film that gets the most hate. Now I can understand this because there are a lot of scenes in there that are just teeth gritting. But for me there are many scenes in The Phantom Menace that just stand out and are just mind blowing. I mean, the pod race, that's for one example, and that's my number 5 on the list. I don't know what it is, everything about the pod race is just so, it's so perfect as a race. Forget cringing characters or weird looking aliens. I mean, some of these aliens do look really good, but I mean the sounds, some of these sounds are these actual pods in these engines. I mean, Sebulba's, you know, it makes this clunking noise. I mean, Ben Burtt must have been right on the ball when he was creating, you know, all these sounds for The Phantom Menace. There are many funny scenes in the pod race as well. And just that spectacular landscape. I mean, George Lucas may have made a bit of a boo-boo with the film, but he wanted to get the best look using the CGI. He just over-CGI'd it. But a lot of the scenes do look really good. And yeah, there's funny scenes with the sand people. That makes me laugh all the every single time. And they are such crap shots as well. Poor little Jake Lloyd as well. He got a lot of hate after this movie. And I don't think he's ever recovered either. I mean, I think he to the point where he got bullied so much that he quit, you know, social media and quit acting, which is a bit of a shame because we never know, you know, he might have been turned out to be a really good actor. A lot of these special, I mean, look at these special effects, they're fantastic. It's just so fast and so wow. And the final shot, that makes me laugh as well. So there we go. Number 4 on my list is from A New Hope, the escape from Yavin there. And it's basically the Death Star trench run. So it's all the X-Wings all gathered. Look, this is the reshot with the CGI. And it does look absolutely spectacular. When you crank that up on your system, you know, in 1080p, it just looks fantastic. The sound is incredible. The whole look of it. I mean, George Lucas took a lot of these shots from old World War II, you know, fighter jets attacking and things like that to get the kind of idea of how he wanted it to look. But when you get a TIE fighter and an X-Wing just hashing it out like this, it actually brings my memories back to when I was at school and I used to go to the arcade and play the Star Wars games. But yeah, the whole trench run is just fantastic. It's the simplest thing as well. And of course we wouldn't have known anything about it if it wasn't for Galen Erso, so good on him. And of course in one of these tacks, poor old Red 5 gets the shit blown out of him as well. So, well. And that's where Luke manages to thingy the call sign, you know, because he actually died, Red 5 actually died in Rogue One. So that left an opening for Luke's character to get the call sign Red 5, which is quite clever. Yeah, some of these explosions are really good. And this was all done model work. I just love the design of the X-Wings and the Y-Wings. They're just so brilliantly designed. This is it. And the just mixture of the colours there, the greens, just the you know, the green lasers just coming out of nowhere. It's funny because a lot of the time when they're shooting off into space, they're not actually shooting at anything. So either they decided not to put in any of the effect shots, or, you know, the Death Star gunners are just absolutely crap shots, just like the fucking stormtroopers. Or Vader and his two henchmen there. Oh yes, my lord, we'll let you take the first shot. Bullseye. Yes, this still remains one of the best scenes ever in Star Wars. But there are better scenes. That's hence why it's number 4 on my list. Oh, poor old Carrie Fisher there. God bless her. So number 3 on my list is the end scene to Return of the Jedi, which is between Luke, the Emperor, and Vader. This scene at the end of Jedi always freaked me out. I was so terrified of this version of the Emperor. He was so straight-faced and he was so... Oh my god, I mean, just look at it, and even the acting from Ian McDiarmid is fantastic. And I never felt that. I never felt so intimidated watching him in The Phantom Menace or any of the prequels. But I don't know what it is, but in Jedi, he really was to be feared. And I was scared shitless of him as a kid. So I don't know, I mean... For me, especially in this film, I think I felt the Emperor was more the villain than Vader ever was the villain. It's just pure hatred, and look at those beautiful electric shocks. Looks like his helmet needs a bit of a shine. There's that little grin that he puts there as well. That's so fantastic. And Lucas did do a couple of editing shots for this. And if I believe I'm right, then when he picks him, when Vader picks the Emperor up in a minute, he puts one of those, no! Which we've had enough of those, because we had that really cringing one at the end of Revenge of the Sith. There was no need for that. No need to put that in at all. Go on, plug in, Daniel. Brilliant. Splat. Number 2 on my list is the Hoth. Basically, the whole Battle of Hoth. And it was so early on in the film, it was totally unexpected. Because you always get battles at the end of films or in the middle, but never at the bloody beginning of a film. And this was fantastic. I mean, the special effects on this, these AT-ATs can live up right now, like however many years later, was it 40 years later? I just love the setting and the snow speeder design. Lucas did a few tweaks with the AT-ATs, you know, with the special effects and that. But yeah, I mean, you would think that this was made today. This is so fantastic, and I love the sound of these AT-ATs. And we're due to get some new ones in the last Jedi. They're supposed to be probably twice the size. So I look forward to seeing them ones. And now my number 1. As you see, the top 2 being from my favourite Star Wars movie of all time. Number 1 is the Dagobah scenes in Empire Strikes Back. It's Yoda, basically. This was our first introduction. And it's just a puppet and a voice. And the magic that it brings to the screen is beyond anything you can imagine. I mean, when they were making it, I they were thinking that this could either be cinema magic or this could just end up being a complete disaster. So I'm glad it didn't go downhill. But Frank Oz, he's fantastic. He just brings so much character to this character. He makes me laugh as well. All this energy and this strength that poor little Yoda's got, and he just hits R2 with a piece of wood. He could have just picked him up, thrown him across into the swamp. That's what I would have done. After all, if you can lift an X-Wing out of a bloody swamp. But yeah, look at that. Just look at that face. A cute little face. And I prefer this Yoda a million times over the Yodas from the prequels. This is pure cinema magic. And the setting, it's just such a beautiful setting. The fog and the little creatures crawling down the trees. The atmospheric sounds. You want to be in a dark room. You want to be in a dark cinema. Nothing else around you. And just crank this up and just be immersed into this absolutely fantastic scene. As he lifts the old X-Wing out. The effortless. Effortless. It's a good job he didn't lose his concentration then, otherwise it would have crashed to the floor. But look at all that mist and all that fog there. It's great. There's the attention to detail and the seaweed type stuff. This scene in The Phantom Menace. This didn't make my top five, unfortunately. I would put it about sixth. But it is still one of the best scenes from the prequels. I mean, this introduction to Darth Maul, especially when these doors open and he ignites his double-bladed saber. That is what got everybody on their edge of the seat. And these scenes, look at the choreography. I mean, they must have trained for ages to get all these scenes. He effortlessly flips over there, Ray Park. He's brilliant. I met him a few times. He signed a couple of my Darth Maul figures. But yeah, oh my God. And the whole setting of it as well, with the lights behind, the colour mixture of the blues, the greens, the reds, the sounds of the lightsabers. This is one of the scenes from Phantom Menace that George Lucas really did get right. And it's a shame that the whole of the film couldn't have been up to this calibre. And just look at that. Look at the sounds. It's just endless. I mean, Liam Neeson, oh my God, he did an absolutely fantastic job here. It's a shame that he had to die.
What do you mean? I haven't seen The Phantom Menace yet. You've ruined it for me.
But yeah, it is a shame that that character had to die, because I would have loved to have seen this character through the rest of the other two films, through the prequels. Oh, there we go. Slice and dice. Oh, poor old Ewan McGregor. He looks so young as well. But this always makes me laugh in a minute. With old Maul here. Oh, come on. He's like egging him on. Come on, you know you want it. And Obi-Wan's like, come on, I want to get you, you bastard. Those moves. He must have trained for months to get those moves. I wonder how many takes they did, but that was fantastic. That is proper Jedi work. Like I said, with Liam Neeson being killed off, I mean, Darth Maul, that is a character I would have loved to have seen through the rest of the prequels as well. Yeah, they killed him at the end of the first episode. Such a shame. Dabble the action.
Well, I hope you enjoyed that little countdown there of my top
5 Star Wars moments. There are many, many more scenes and moments that I would love to have put in the chart, but I was only sticking to a top 5, otherwise we would have ended up about a top 50. But if your scenes or your moments differ, which probably many will, stick them down in the comments, because I'd be interested to see what your favourite film moments are from all of the films. There's a lot of Star Wars news going about at the moment, what with The Last Jedi only a couple of months away, and also the Han Solo movie, which is going to be next May. There's still a lot of uncertainty about whether that's going to be accepted, being not Harrison Ford, but we'll see. But they've also just announced as well that the next standalone movie after Episode 9 will be an Obi-Wan Kenobi movie. Now, fingers crossed that Ewan McGregor has another chop, because I can't see anybody else playing Obi-Wan. He's well stuck into the role now, and he's actually said that he would love to do it again. So we'll see how that goes, but I think that's going to be out in about 2020, I think it is. God, we're all going to be a lot older by then, aren't we? Also, a lot of Star Wars fans believe that the thermal exhaust port is 3 millimeters to the left. It's not, it's actually 3 millimeters to the right. So that's another discussion for a later date, but if you know Star Wars, you know where the thermal exhaust port is. So thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you on the next top 5 video. Bye.